Thanks for stopping by and have a little look at this video. I'm going to do another one of the best races that you can do in the game. It's the best paying races as you're going through the game. So some of them are going to be higher end stuff and some of them are going to be a bit lower than that. Obviously, if the ones that are in the Legend series and Master and stuff, they're no use to you if you are on the lower end of the scale of things as you're going through. So once you actually really start thinking about you need to start earning money in this game, I think you're probably going to be somewhere around a pro level. So that's what I'm going to do today. And a pro level, there's quite a few different series in here. The best one used to be in this classic American Muscle. There was an endurance event near a speedway. And that you could regularly clock up over 200 miles on the endurance, but they actually stopped the way the robots appeared on the track, so you can't actually do that anymore. So the best one in pro, there's a few that all pay about the same sort of money, racing dollars wise, and they're in the Supercar Master Series. Now there's a few on here that pay about the same amount of money, as I said, but the one I think you should be doing first and keeping at is number 16. 16. What if I press the right one? And it's this one here, the 16C, the Cup at Silverstone on the Grand Prix circuit, the 2009 version. Don't get too carried away what you read on the internet about stuff. It says whatever races as you go through the game, it's worth, you know, 15,000 or 10,000 or 50,000, whatever it says, because it's just the bare bones of what you get. The way you earn money at this, I need to make sure this loads up the friends, because it's, if you haven't got any friends on here, you don't get the full amount of money. You want to get as many friends as you can, so when you've done this race a couple of times, once you've won it once, all your the whole grid will line up full of your friends. And they don't want to seem to load on it. Normally if you go back and then back onto it again, see the little wheels are going around, that's normally that is loading all your friends list up. So you need to make sure that has come on there first. I'm actually going to go, oh, it started loading then, typical. But you want to make sure they're loaded first before you race it. Right, so they're loaded on now. You will only get this the first time you race it, you'll only race probably a few friends at most. But then when you revisit the race, that's when you're going to get the most benefit out of it. So it's this one here, 16C then, so I'm going to click into that. This is the first race of the day, and you'll want to use the best car you have got to win. And I think there's a PR of 45 or 46 for this one. The ones further on, there's a higher PR, so you might not qualify in your car. Now, the fact I've raced this, you know, quite a few times in the past, I'm going to use the Audi, because you can't normally see that as it goes around the track. It's a little bit inconspicuous. So you can win it in virtually any of them anyway, to be honest. I'm going to go in this Audi, because it's the best car I've got available. And then when it comes on, I'm going to, as you can see there, every name there is in yellow. That means that every one of them is on your friends list, or your Google Plus circles, whichever you are logged into. And obviously the other one is Game Center on iOS. Now you need to hire the first manager. You get a choice before the race starts or just prior to it starting, when the race first opens, sorry, or coming up now. So this one here, Michael, I'm gonna hire him. It's going to cost me one gold to show you, but this is the way you want to do it. So you hire him, it's the first race of the day. And I think if you look on the web, it will say this race is worth about 15 or 18,000, 19,000 actually, something I think it might say. It's actually worth far more than that. If you do it, you know, race it at the right time and use the managers and stuff. Obviously you have got to make sure you win. It's quite a long track this Silverstone. As Sean Pierce knows, he's been round it. I've been to Silverstone a few times, never been on the circuit like Sean has. Even if it was in a van. But he's still gone round the circuit. I'd like to go round the circuit. I'd go round the circuit quite happily on a push bike. Very nearly overshot that. But there's so many names of these bins, I don't remember what any of them are called. Now when I've been to Silverstone a couple of times, I've always been to the same place in the grandstand. And it's this bit as we come round here, some green stands in front of you there. I've been into these stands on the left hand side. And up on this next corner here. Now this corner, when you're here, you can't believe the cars, the F1 cars go around this corner flat out. They do not brake at all. Oh, perhaps I should have braked a bit more. Oh, I tried to get a bit of a nudge, helping hand off him, and I missed. It's quite interesting, that video of Sean Pierce's that he's got on there. Because he does talk you through all the different corners and roughly how fast the you know, the proper cars are going around it. Sure is a fast old track this Silverstone. Depending on what, how many friends you've got and you know the how fast are they actually push me off there, how fast they actually drive will depend on what car you really need for this race. Because I've got, I must have about 500 I think these days, but in that there's a lot of people that have got fully upgraded cars, and I've obviously been around the track many times as well. So it makes it that bit harder to win these days. But if you've only got, you know, 25 or 30 friends, whatever, hopefully they'll still fill that up for you on a regular basis. But you can do this one. So there are a few you can do, but this one you need less of a PR to enter the race, or an IP it's called if you're French, and an LW I think if you're German. And also there's the you know, if you really want to build your money up, you don't want to lose, there's obviously a lot of opportunity for corner cutting on here if you want to make sure you get your racing dollars banked. I don't do corner cutting, but I have done it in the past, don't you worry. I've got two laps left and I'm getting pushed, something terrible. The noise they go down here, I'm normally up on this bottom left-hand corner here, seeing them as they go around the corner, at this corner. Been to the touring car quite a few times. I went last year and the year before. That's the BTCC. And that banging at the car engines, mate, is fantastic. But to me, there's nothing as good as the sound of a Formula One car. I've been, you know, Silverstone a couple of times and Brands Hatch. And the noise of a Formula One car is like no other noise, I don't think. Right, so I've got this one in my sights here. Take it fairly easy. One lap to go, I should be able to nick it off of him. He's pretty fast though, I'll give him that. He's trying his damnest. I much prefer races like this when you got to work for it to win. There's too many races in my opinion on this game that I mean, most of my cars aren't upgraded. Not fully upgraded. They are upgraded, but they're not fully upgraded. And some of the races, in fact, almost all of the races are too easy to win. So I like it when you've got to work to win. Yeah, I think if you do a search on the internet how much money you get for this rate, winning this race, I'm sure it says it's about 19,000. Which is probably about right. And this is one of three or four that pay the same money on this series. Some of the other series, Deutsche Jewel and stuff, they don't pay very good money at all. This particular series, is pretty fruitful. I say this is a race, in my opinion, is where you want to have your first race of the day if you are in pro level, working towards your expert level, trying to build your bank account up to buy your Aston Martins and Mercedes and what have you. I must have a look at Sean's video one day and do a side-by-side where he's showing you where you should be driving and how I actually do line up on my racing lines to see how far out I am. Right, so 19,000 that's saying we're going to get. I can guarantee you we'll be clocking up a bit more than 19,000. Right, so we've got there 77,600 plus a bit of clean race bonus. We're now going to kick in with our friends' money, so that would worth 19,500 just for your beating your friends. You have obviously got to win this to get this money, by the way. You're not just going to get this if you come second or third. So in total that was worth 105,000 racing dollars. Now, as I said, on the internet, if you look it up, it says you win about 19,000. So you really need to dismiss all that false information that they're chucking out on the internet, because it's not right. This is the way to top your money up, and this is, you know, generally how much you're going to be getting. But there are three or four races like that, but you need to do it in a way I just showed you. If you've got any questions, then you can leave me a comment. I do answer almost all of them. I answer almost all of them as soon as I can anyway. Obviously if it's late then you won't get a reply till the next day, but a lot of the time it's within, you know, within an hour or whatever. So I hope you've enjoyed that, and I'll come back with another race tomorrow in a different series. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you again on another one. Cheers.